We're able to do all this because of the cooperative relationships that we have been formed around the operation of Glen Canyon Dam. The interests that brought this protocol home are multiple. They include the 7 Colorado River Basin states, 5 Native American tribes that are represented in the Glen Canyon Adaptive Management Program, 6 federal agencies in 2 different departments, recreation and environmental interests, power purchasers and power distributors. The protocol requires that any release be done in accordance with the law of the river. And that ensures that we continue to meet our obligations to deliver water downstream for water supply, for Western communities, for the many tribes that rely on the Colorado River, for agriculture, generating power that goes through the entire southwestern grid. It represents a balancing of many different interests. We have the interest in generation of clean, renewable hydropower. We have the interest in providing reliability to the water supplies in the southwest. This river provides water to 31 million people and 5 million acres of irrigated land, some of the most valuable cropland in the entire world. It provides water to many Native American tribes. And we're also preserving unmatched national treasures. This whole experiment is based on science. We're talking about decades of river science here, geomorphology, fish and wildlife biology, cultural resource assessment. It also remains an experiment, so we're learning by doing. This high flow release, I think, embodies the commitment of the Obama administration and of Secretary Sally Jewell to balanced conservation.